Basic English, our subject code is 101F. So today's our lesson is Classroom English. So this is the second topic in our English. What will happen after the completion of this class? On completing this lesson, you will be able to identify expressions used in the class. The second one is use classroom expressions meaningfully. So what will happen here? You will identify what kind of sentences or phrases we can use in the class by the teacher or by the student. So let us see, discuss the expressions given below. Try and guess the situation in which they are used. Okay, so today we will discuss something, that what kind of sentences or phrases used by the teacher in the class. Okay, for example, that's all for today. That's all for today. So who will use this sentence? This sentence always uses by your teacher. That's all for today. When your teacher use this sentence? If he completes his class, if he feel that the students tied at that time, teacher will take a decision, or after ringing the bell, he will decide to leave the class. At that time, he uses this word. What is that? That's all for today. That's all for today. Next, another phrase or sentence. How many are absent today? How many are absent today? When your teacher used this sentence, your teacher used this sentence if he wants to know that how many students were absent on that day. Okay, so at that time, how he use? How many are absent today? What is it? This is question. This question is used by your teacher in the class. And let us we try to know some of the expressions used by teacher in the class. Were you present on that day? Were you present on that day? When the teacher asking particular a person, Ramu, were you present on that day? Or Kavita, were you present on that day? So your teacher will ask like this if he wants to know particular about a person's present or absent. Okay, for example, Ramu, were you present on that day when I conducted a slip test? Yes, sir, I presented. No, sir, I was not presented on that day. So this is the expression used by teacher. He will ask the question to know whether a person is present or absent. Here, what is using? The teacher using were, W-E-R-E. Were you present on that day? What is this? This is a question asked by the teacher. What is using? Were is using. What is were? Were is an helping verb. Were tells us about the past, not the present. If it is present, are you present today? Okay. Will you present tomorrow? So your teacher will ask different questions in different situations. So here you remember that was and were. Okay, these two words are used to know about the past things only. Okay, right. Now let us try to know another sentence. Let's start the lesson. Let us start the lesson, or let's start the lesson. When we use this sentence, okay, after entering into the class, when your lecturer is going to start the lesson, at the time, sometimes he may use this word. What is that? Let's start the lesson. Let's start the lesson. What it means that your lecturer is going to start the lesson. He wants to alert the students. At that time, he uses this sentence. Okay. Next, let us see and some more expressions which used by the teacher. Look at the first activity on page number 24. Who uses this sentence in the class? When lecturer gives you to do the activities, that may be pair work or that may be group work, sometimes your lecturer uses this sentence. What is that? Look at the first activity on page number 24. What will happen at that time? All the students will turn the page number 24. Okay. So this also used by the teacher in the class. And here some more information is also given. Say it again. Say it again. Okay. This sentence sometimes used by the teacher and sometimes the same sentence used by the student also. For example, say it again. If your lecturer asks any question, you'll give answer sometimes. If the lecturer could not understand the exact what you said at that moment, sometimes your lecturer will ask you, say it again. Say it again. And sometimes this sentence also uses by the student also. If lecturer tells about anything, maybe that is tenses, active voice, passive voice or anything. If you could not understand, then you ask. If you do not understand anything, at the time you can say this sentence with your teacher. What is that? Excuse me, sir. Will you repeat it, sir? Or say it again, sir. I could not understand, sir. So you can use like this kind of sentences. And we discuss some more phrases or sentences which is used by the teacher or lecturer in the class. Why don't you say it loudly? Pinky, why don't you say it loudly? Radha, why don't you say it loudly? Ramana, why don't you say it loudly? So sometimes he uses this sentence also in the class. Okay. So, and moreover, we discuss some more information in the today's class. Read the whole sentence. Read the whole sentence. And who knows the answer? Who will use this sentence in the class? Your teacher, your lecturer will use this one. Who knows the answer? Or who is your partner? If your lecturer is giving you pair work, then he will ask the students, who is your partner to do this pair work, to complete this task? And don't have a discussion when your lecturer is delivering a speech. If anybody is disturbing due to any reason, if anybody is making noise at the time, lecturer uses this sentence. Don't have a discussion. Don't have a discussion. Or don't make noise. So there are many other expressions also there used by the teacher in the class. Okay, we will discuss some more expressions in the next class. This is enough for today. Thank you.